Good afternoon. Let others join first. Within 5 minutes, your class will start. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So yesterday we discussed. Okay, fine. Thank you. So yesterday we discussed up to this. Okay, the RL circuit. Okay, series RL circuit we discussed, and what is their total impedance value? That is Z. Okay, so Z equals to root under of R square plus XL square, right? And okay, and you already know from this impedance triangle, okay, we didn't have time to discuss this one. So from this impedance triangle, what we are observing that this impedance has one magnitude, okay, and an angle, right? Either it is phi or theta, that's up to you, okay? So whether you are writing it phi or mod z angle theta, that's up to you, okay? So when you are representing this impedance, then you have to represent either in polar form or in Cartesian form.
Okay.
Now look that this system, this Z angle phi, okay, we can convert this as per the Cartesian format. How? A plus IB. Like that. Okay. And in our AC representation, this x-axis represents the real part, okay, and the imaginary axis represents the imaginary part, this y-axis, okay, this represents the imaginary part. So if I convert this system, this z equals to mod z angle phi, so what we can write, if we want to write as Cartesian format or rectangular format, anyone tell me if you know?
Whenever we are studying alternating quantities, that is either it is alternating voltage or alternating current,
is my question clear to everyone?
One important characteristics of alternating quantities is that,
yes or no?
Now that makes alternating quantities a bit complex to study. Because
yes or no? Voice is very slow.
Yes, sir.
So you have
no, sir.
Okay.
So there is, noise, sir, in your background.
Yes, sir.
What are the
changes? No, actually, another class is going on. That's why. Okay.
Since
see here.
That's why we can't hear, sir.
Is dependent on that.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. Now, listen. Here, this is your z equals to mod z angle phi. Okay, so this is basically the polar format. As you know, this is called the polar format.
Okay?
And if you convert this polar format into rectangular format, we will write this one as z cos theta plus j into z sine theta. Okay. Now, what is z cos theta here from this impedance triangle? What is z cos theta? Z cos theta means this part. R. Yes or no?
Yes.
And what is z sine theta? Z sine theta is your XL. Correct? So, in place of z cos theta, I can write R. And in place of z sine theta, I can write xl. Okay, so this is the actual representation of the impedance. Clear? This is the actual representation of the impedance, that is R plus jxl. Okay, this z is the called the impedance, and whose magnitude is root under of r square plus xl square and argument angle phi. Correct? And if we want to convert this polar format into rectangular format, it will be R plus J XL. And why positive sign? Because it is in positive x axis, a positive y axis. Okay. Now, next, we will discuss this RC circuit.
Is this scheme
okay? So in RC circuit, what will happen when one voltage source is connected across the RC? Then one current will flow, and this is your VR, and this is your I. So if I want to draw the phasor diagram, yes. Which form? Okay. Rectangular form means you have to convert. Okay, just a minute. Rectangular form means you have to convert like this, x plus I1. Okay. Since our x axis represents the real value and the vertical axis, or you can say y axis, represents the. Okay. This is your actually x, okay, and this represents the imaginary value. Okay, so if I am right, and if you take the resultant, this is your R, okay, and this is your suppose theta. So your rectangular format is x plus iy. And if you want to convert that into polar format, it will be R angle theta. Okay, so what is the value of R? R value is root under of x square plus y square. Correct? And what is the value of theta? Theta is tan inverse. Okay, this is actually tan inverse y by x. Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that
okay. Okay, so let me erase this part. Just a minute. Actually, this drawing portion, it will be good if I have one blackboard. Okay. Then you can understand it very easily. Side by side, I will draw. And you will learn that from that drawing. Okay. But here I have very little space. So it is very, I am so uncomfortable with this type of thing. Okay, fine. No issue. Since we have to do this in this online format, so we have to learn like this. Okay. Now, this is your RC circuit. Okay. Now, when current flows through the resistance, then what will happen? The voltage developed across the resistor and the current, they will be in phase. Okay, So if I draw the phasor diagram, this is your I. Okay, try to understand. This is your VR. Is it clear? Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next. In case of capacitor, what will happen? Let's check the previous slides. Okay, see here. In case of capacitor, V lags the current. Okay, that means current will lead the voltage. Now, this thing depends on the reference. Okay, so here, what is your reference in RC circuit? Which one is your reference? Current is your reference. Okay, current is your reference here. So, current will lead the voltage. That means voltage will be in lagging. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what we have to do, we have to calculate the resultant voltage. Okay, so what is your resultant voltage? Tell me. What is the value of resultant voltage? Right. So, V equals to under root, and don't forget to put here magnitude because this is one vector. So, it must have one angle. Okay, it must have one angle. So, this is your VR square plus VC square. Correct? Now, what is the angle? This angle is your suppose theta. So, what is the value of theta? Tell me.
45 degrees.
Why 45 degrees?
Now, so, tan inverse VC by VR.
Tan inverse VC by VR.
Exactly. Tan inverse VC by VR. Now, you already told the 90% of the answer. Okay. Look here. Where is VC? VC is in minus Y axis. Right, so here either you put minus VC or you write this theta is lagging. Now, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
I am also showing the vector rotation. This is the having the velocity value of
omega radians
per second.
Now, theta is lagging. So, what is your final answer in case of RC circuit? Final answer is current I will always lead the final resultant voltage by angle.
Theta.
Is that clear? Because look, here current I is here, but voltage is in minus theta lagging. So since I is your reference, so we have to say everything with respect to the reference voltage. Okay, so we will say that I leads the voltage by the angle theta. Correct. Here, why I am writing theta lagging? Because here theta, you can write lagging or you simply put VC here. Okay. You can say here that theta is tan inverse minus VC by VR. And why I say this lagging? Because V is lagging by I. So, both are correct. This one and this one. Both are correct. Okay? But try to write this one. Okay? This one is, try to write like this. Because see, here current is your reference, not voltage. Okay? Is it clear now?
In question, yes, sir.
How can we assume that we will be reference?
Ah, very good question. Okay. See, I am drawing two types of circuit here. I don't have any place to draw. Okay, just a minute. Here. Just a minute.
The only difference lies in the fact that here here comes a question of rank or position in the vector. Okay, since the vector, okay,
let me share the screen first, rate, just a minute.
It is moving in the anti-clockwise direction, and it is depicting that how these angular differences are getting changed. Like first it was 30 degree, then it was 60 degree, then it was 90, and again it got 120, then 150, and then reverse the direction, and so on and so on. So that is why we say this
is the screen visible?
Actually representing.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how will you describe or how will you say which one is
by more different? Circle of this particular angle, that is 360 degree, which can be very easily depicted on a sinusoidal.
Okay. So is this visible? Visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. Now I am drawing two kinds of circuit. One is series.
And your graph is shown above. A sinusoidal waveform will be drawn starting at the
one
left.
One is your series circuit.
Indicates the time that
has another one
time.
Is your
when the vector is
parallel circuit.
Of the
okay. Now in series circuit, no. When current is flowing, this is your V, this is your R, this is your L. Okay. When current is flowing, the same current is flowing in R and L, right? So always remember that value will be your reference. That variable will be taken as your reference, which is same for all the elements. Okay, here look, in series circuit, current is same for R, L, and if I connect one capacitor here, so current will be same for all the elements. Correct?
Now,
so here, current is your reference.
Now,
now tell me, in case of parallel circuit, what will be your reference?
Voltage will be our reference.
Voltage will be our reference, exactly. So in this case, so in two cases, for these two cases, let me draw the phasor diagram. Okay, here this is your current, this is your VR.
That means, whenever we are
this is your V
R,
and this is your VL. And you can say that V equals to VR equals to VL, or parallel case. Okay, so first, complete this one. Then this is your second. So, this is your VR, and VL will be in positive Y axis. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, the phase of
then draw the resultant diagram.
Is represented by a phasor diagram. So, phasor diagrams can be thought of as functions of time. A completely sine wave
can't be constructed
by a single vector.
Total voltage.
Rotating at an angular velocity omega.
This is your theta. So, what will I say? That current is lagging in case with respect to V. Or you can say that V.
This thing
is
you always have to keep in mind.
Leading. Okay. Or you can say, in case of this type of circuit, always try to say with respect to the current. Okay. So I will say that this one is correct. Current lags the voltage by theta angle. This one is correct because see, this is the inductive circuit because R and L is here. Okay, so current will always lag the voltage by angle theta. Okay, and in case of this parallel circuit, what will happen? Voltage is your reference. That is V, and this is your current. So current will be divided into IR and IL, and you have to remember that IR and GR must be in phase. Correct? So, IR will be here. It must be in phase. Right? Because VR equals to V and VL also equals to correct? And in case of inductor, what will happen? VL is leading the current. Yes? So here voltage is here. So current will be in lagging condition. Right? So now we are going to draw the vector for the current only, because voltage is same for both the cases. मतलब this resistor के लिए भी और inductor के लिए भी voltage same है. Okay? So here we are going to draw the phasor diagram of the current. Because see, currents are different. IR and IL. So this is your total current. Okay? So what will we say here? We will say that V leads the current
by drawing out the two phasor by graph paper. Their phasor sum V1
theta
easily found by measuring the range of the diagonal line known as the resultant vector.
Is the concept clear?
Yes, sir.
No confusion now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now,
to the downside of the graphical method of okay, just a minute. What I actually told you that for a vector addition to happen.
Next, we will discuss the RLC circuit. Okay, like you performed in lab. So let me share the screen again.
And from this, we can then calculate both the particle and voltage.
Okay, so this one is the RC circuit.
This analytical method which uses a cosine and a cosine to find the resultant angle is commonly called the rectangular form. So with this particular
okay, so this is this visible? Is the screen visible? Okay, good. So here look, what is the mathematical equation that we already discussed? V squared equals to VR squared plus VC squared, correct? And this is the VR equals to IR and VC equals to XC. And what is the value of XC? Tell me.
All the other various factors.
1 by omega C. Exactly. 1 by omega C. Okay. Now, V squared equals to I squared R squared plus I squared XC squared. So here, again, another impedance you are getting. Okay. So here, look, this is your vector diagram. From here, you are getting the voltage triangle. Now from here, draw the impedance triangle. Okay. This is your vector triangle and voltage triangle. And then we are drawing the impedance triangle. Okay, so this is your R, this is your X, C, this is your Z. So this kind of RC circuit is called capacitive circuit. Okay, when RL circuit is present in your system, that is called inductive circuit. Correct. So here look, this is your Z. This is your minus pi or minus theta as per your calculation, right? So what we can say here, we can write this z vector equals to r minus j x c.
How we can write this? We will consider two components.
Is it right?
A and B. Let A equals to x plus zero and B equals to w plus.
कोई confusion नहीं है ना किसी के पास? If you have any slightest confusion, tell me now.
That is one for.
Okay, fine. So no confusion till now. Good. So what is the magnitude? This is your magnitude. Root under of R square plus XC square. Okay. So look here. That is Z. this impedance is not one simple numerical quantity. It is one complex quantity. Just like the complex number you had learned in 11, 12 mathematics. Okay, Z is one complex quantity, or you can say vector quantity, because it has some real value and some imaginary value. Right. Next one, this phase angle you can calculate very easily. Okay, so this one is one simple numerical. A sinusoidal voltage supply defined as Vt equals to 100 into cos omega t plus 30. Okay, so can anyone say this waveform of Vt, is it leading voltage or lagging voltage with respect to the reference axis?
So leading.
Yes, sir, leading.
Leading.
Very good. So our waveform will look like, okay, this one is cosine curve. Okay, so this one will be a little bit different. Okay. This curve is your cosine curve. So your curve will start from here. It will move like this. So this is your 30 degree. Okay, this is your 30 degree. Correct? Okay, is it clear to everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, it is connected across one pure resistance of 50 ohm. Now, determine its impedance and the peak value of the current flowing through the circuit. Okay, and draw the corresponding phasor diagram. So it is very easy for you, because VR, this is already given, connected to a pure. Okay, so you can calculate the IR value, because voltage is already across the resistor. So this is your VR. This voltage is connected across the resistor. So this voltage VT equals to VR, right? So VR divided by R, that you can calculate, 100 angle 30 degree divided by 50, so 2 angle 30. Correct? Now, how can we write this? Okay, this one means, look, this one is very easy to understand. This 100 cos of omega t plus 30, it means what? It means the waveform starts in 30 degree leading with respect to the reference axis, that is 0, 0 point. Okay, and here if you denote like this, this voltage like this 100 angle 30 degree, then that also gives you the idea that this is the magnitude and this 30 degree is your leading angle. That means if this is your phasor reference diagram, then this is your voltage. Okay, so this conversion is possible. Concept clear, Mohan?
So now we understand that if I
is the concept clear?
A sinusoidal supply, and we are having a pure.
Yes, sir.
So if there I put one minus sign, then your phasor diagram will be in below like this.
See, there is also a switch here. So now when
this will be your voltage, correct? If negative sign is there. Right, so since here positive sign is present, so I am erasing this one. Okay. See, I am telling you all types of questions that may come in your exam. Okay, here positive sign is given, but in exam, negative sign may be given. Right, it may be given. So you don't know, I don't know. So try to learn all kinds of problems. Right, so here, this is your current value, that is 2 angle 30 ampere. And if you want to convert this as waveform, then what will I write? I will write 2 cos omega t plus 30 degree.
Okay.
So current and voltage both are in phase. So that will be your phasor diagram. Okay, just a minute, I am having one call. তাহলে একাডেমিক সেকশন নাই বল চলে যাও আমি নিতে পারিনি ওটা একাডেমিক সেকশনে গিয়ে বল
হ্যাঁ চলে যা
ঠিক আছে আমাকে একটা মেসেজ করে দিন হ্যাঁ ক্লাস নিচ্ছি Okay, so the corresponding phasor diagram and the value of current, the value of impedance, that is already known to you. Correct. Now, second question. In this type of circuit, the supply voltage is defined as 325 sine 3140 minus 30 degrees and L equals to 2.2 Henry. So first of all, tell me what is the frequency of this waveform. Quickly tell me what is the frequency.
So if I draw
down
the phasor diagram. C14/2π.
Yes? C14/2π. So what is the value?
Sir, 50.
50 hertz, exactly. See, always remember this kind of, what is the value of pi? Always remember that pi value is up to 2 decibel point. Is 3.14. So if you multiply with 2 and 50, so it will be 100 pi. So 100 pi means what? 314. Okay, so always keep that in mind that if 314 is given as angular frequency, the frequency, original frequency of the waveform will be 50 hertz. Correct? Now, is the waveform leading or lagging? Which one? This voltage waveform.
Lagging, sir.
With respect to the reference axis. Right. Next, L value is given. Now, determine the value of RMS current.
So, B and R will be the same
সময়টাই রেজিস্ট্রেশন বলছে Okay. Now here, look, the inductor is present here. Okay. So, in our normal concept, this VL value and the relation between VL and IL, which one will be leading? Tell me. VL will always lead. Correct. Exactly. So, look here. The V total voltage is given here, right? And this voltage is actually VL, correct? So here, VL value will be lagging by the angle 30 degree with the reference axis. Is the correct? Is this correct?
They are forming a linear
Okay. Look the phasor diagram. VL is lagging with the reference axis. Correct. Then, we already know that if inductor is present, this will be your VL and this is your IL or I. Okay. So that means what? The VL will always be leading by 90 degrees. Correct? So IL will always be lagging by 90 degrees. Correct? So here look, IL is lagging by 90 degrees.
And then we have I,
okay.
Is the current.
Is this clear?
That is I by 2 equals to I L sine omega 2.
Now, is this clear to everyone?
Okay. And.
Or is there any problem?
You can see it from the diagram also that we do not have any angular difference. That is theta angle here is 0. So suppose the graph has started from here.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so is this phasor diagram clear to you or clear to everyone?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. See, this is your... Yes, what question?
Just after seeing the question, how can we argue the answer that it's lagging or not?
See, the difference between the difference of these two
based on the reference value, you have to say that.
This point is
okay.
A.
Based on the reference value, you have to say that. Here, look, what is your reference? IL is your reference. Okay, I is your reference. So, based on I, you have to say whether VL is leading or lagging. Correct. So, look, this is your reference. Okay, try to understand. I am discussing again. This is your reference. Okay, so with respect to this reference, this V voltage is 30 degree lagging. Correct. So I am drawing the voltage phasor that is 30 degree lagging. Okay. That's why it is minus 30 degree.
This will be
because it is lagging. Okay. Next, as per our concept, voltage and current in case of inductor, what is the relationship? The voltage will always lead by 90 degrees. Correct? If only inductor is present. Isn't it? If only inductor is present, then voltage will lead by 90 degrees. So here voltage is present here. So obviously current will be lagging by 90 degrees.
Now,
yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. If voltage is here, voltage is given here, then current will lag by 90 degrees. Okay. So just like that, this is your VL or V, you can say. And here, with respect to voltage, 90 degree angle is lagging. And there is your current phasor. This is your current phasor. Now, is it clear?
In each case, it lags by 90 degrees.
Only if inductor is there. Only if inductor is there. Okay. If only inductor is there, then this will happen. Only inductor is present. Suppose, at that time, this 90 degree will be leading. Because see now, here, just let me show you.
So I want to say that if there is R and C circuit.
Yes, 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 I will discuss that. Just a minute, just a minute. Let me solve this numerical, then I will directly shift to RLC circuit.
Okay.
Okay. So this one, so how much angle I is lagging by how much angle with respect to reference?
90 degrees.
With respect to reference, this is your reference line.
120.
Exactly. So I is lagging with respect to the reference line by 120 degrees. Okay, now let us check by calculation whether it is 120 degree lagging or not. Okay, now L value is known to you. So from L, how will you convert this Henry into Ohm? You have to convert it into the reactance, that is XL. Okay, so what is the value of XL? That is omega L. Okay, what is the value of omega? That is 314. Okay, so 314 into 2.2. So that value is your XL. Correct. So your XL value is, look, it is 690. If you calculate, it will give almost 690. Right? Now, this value, IL, magnitude, IL, I am not going by this calculation. Okay, try to do like this calculation. What is the magnitude? That is the magnitude of voltage. That means 325 divided by, what is the value of XL? That is 690.
Take the phasors.
Okay,
the phasor,
325 volt, and this one is 690 ohm. Okay, now if you calculate this value, this will give you the peak value of the current. Try to understand.
Are two vectors, well. That is, A is equal to x plus dy.
Okay, but in case of AC, we always represent our answer in RMS form. Is this clear? Is this clear to you? Because what is this? What is 325? That is nothing but your V max. Isn't it? This is basically your V max. Okay, that is not RMS value. So how to calculate the RMS value? For AC circuit, the RMS value is maximum value by root 2. Okay, so that's why this 325 must be divided by root 2. Okay, so if you divide it by root 2, you will get this 230 approx. Okay, so next, this IL value, whatever value you calculate, that is your peak value you are getting. So what is the peak value you are getting? Tell me after calculation.
Just the way you have done your vector addition or phasor addition, the same manner you
after calculation, what is your peak value? Okay. Tell me.
Instead of having a summation, the real parts and the imaginary parts will have a subtraction. Like here,
hello. Am I audible to everyone?
Vectors. So as for
Okay, so this value is 0.47. So this is your peak value.
Final phasor.
Okay, but in AC case, we always represent our waveform in the case of the RMS value. So if I divide this 0.47 by root 2, then that is your actual answer. Because see here, RMS current value is required. Okay, RMS current value is required. So this ampere is your RMS current. Okay, now calculate this one. What value you are getting? Tell
0.33.
Exactly. So that value is 0.33. So 0.33 is your RMS value. Okay.
Yes.
This is your magnitude. And what is your angle? You already had calculated here. That is 120 degree. Okay. And obviously that is in minus. Look here. This is minus. So, your total answer is 0.33 minus 120 degree. Now, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, everyone, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Now, how you will get by this calculation? Now, this calculation is okay, now. Next. Every time you cannot draw this kind of phasor diagram, okay, when you are doing the three-phase circuit analysis, then this phasor diagram drawing will be very complicated. Okay, so we will solve like this process that is shown here. Okay, let me discuss this process. Okay. Look here, here already VL value is calculated. Okay. What is already known to us? That IL can be calculated by VL by XL. Okay. But XL is in imaginary axis, correct? Because in your impedance triangle, this is your R, this is your XL, okay? So XL is an imaginary axis, that's why here we will write J. Okay, now, this is in Cartesian form, so we need to convert this in polar form. Okay, so if you convert this JXL, the polar form will be XL angle 90 degree. Okay. Now, what is the value of VL? The VL value is 325 angle minus 30 degree. Okay. And this is your peak voltage. So, we need to convert this into RMS voltage first, divided by what is your XL value? That is 690 angle 90 degree. Okay. So after calculation, you will get the same result. That is 0.33 angle minus 120. Now, is this clear or I need to repeat again? Is the calculation clear? Yes, clear. Yes, okay, to everyone, is it clear?
Yes,
sir. Okay, fine. So now only one numerical is left. So I will give that numerical in your WhatsApp group. You can solve that in your on your own. Okay, that is very easy. If you know the basic concept, you can do any type of problem. Okay, now, okay, that is already 350. Okay, after this, do you have any class?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, then I am extending this only 5 minutes. Okay, I will tell the RLC circuit that is already done in your lab. Okay, that kind of circuit I will discuss in short, because tomorrow class I will discuss it in again. Okay. So just a minute. Okay, all of you give your attendance in the box. Okay. All of you give your attendance in the box, chat box. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, the circuit you configured in your lab, that is R, L, and C, all are in series. Correct? This is your voltage. Okay. This is your I. So what will be your reference vector? What will be your reference?
I.
Very good. So this is your I. Okay. And here VR voltage will be developed. Here VL voltage will be developed. Here VC voltage will be developed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the relation between I and VR? They will be in phase. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. VL, that will be in positive y-axis. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And VC will be in negative y-axis.
Negative.
Excellent. Now, what are the conditions? In first condition, if you remember, VL was equal to VC. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if VL and VC, they equal, if they are equal, VL equals to VC, then will there be any y-axis component?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So in first case, our in first case, this will be your I, this is your VR, okay, so no y-axis component, okay, second, VL is greater than VC, third case, VL is less than VC. So what will happen if VL is greater than VC? Which y-axis component will be there, positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive.
Positive. Very good. So this is your positive component. That will be little bit less because VL minus VC is present here. Okay, so this is your resultant voltage, VS, that is your source voltage, okay? Correct? So what is the value of VS? VS equals to VR square plus VL minus VC square under root. Okay? In third case, what will happen? In third case, negative y-axis component will be present. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, likewise, this will be your VC minus VL. Okay. So, whatever voltage you are getting, that is your VS. Okay. And see, in each case, you are getting one angle, that is theta. Okay. So, cosine of this angle is called the power factor. That is called, that is already written in your manual. Okay. So, this is the basic concept. But look,
it's always less than one.
Which one is less than one?
Cosine theta.
Cosine theta value must be between 0 and 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it must not be negative at any time. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so see, one more difference is there. Here, a pure inductor is considered. Look here, pure inductor is considered. Only L is present. But in practical case, this inductor is not pure. There is one small resistance, small R, and L is already present. Okay? So that's why this R is told to calculate by the equations. Okay? Concept clear over?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So that is the main concept of RLC circuit that you experimented in lab. Okay, so with this I am concluding today's class, and this is already in your syllabus. I will discuss this in next class. That is your RLC circuit and resonance condition. Okay, so all of you, I hope you have given your attendances. Okay,
thank you, fine. Sir.
Okay, thank you everyone. You may leave the meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.